Hello, Reuben here for Sonokinetic, and I'm excited to show you around our Idiophones. This collection includes deeply sampled instruments, marimba, xylophone, Glockenspiel and Crotales, captured in our studio in the Netherlands with our aligned microphone setup, giving complete tonal flexibility. Here's a brief excerpt of one of our inspiring demos. We aimed to keep these instruments as fuss-free as possible, but in true Sonokinetic fashion, we did add some features during development that make things more flexible, and sometimes just because. The main interface is very calming, with just a depiction of each individual instrument and the available microphones hanging above it. We call this Zen mode. Drag the mic icons up to bring them closer to the instrument, so they're louder, and down to push them away, softer, and ultimately purge them from RAM. The main play methods of the instrument are also available through Snapshots, so if you don't feel like delving into the interface or the key switches, you can just use these, just here. They're categorized into lots of different subsections. Click on the instrument to access more detailed options in the edit mode. You can move the active microphones around the soundstage here, where left is closest to the instrument in terms of impulse response type and delay, and up adds more reverb level. Drag mic icons all the way down to turn the reverb off. Add mics into the soundstage to create your own bespoke sound from intimate to expansive. At the bottom of the screen, you'll see an overview of the available key switches in our dynamic dual key switching system. The primary key switches are on the white keys between C0 and G0, and within each primary key switch there are 5 secondary key switches on the black keys C-sharp 0 to A-sharp 0. The primary key switch categories are the same for all 5 instruments. C0 for mallet selection, D0 and E0 are for play style, F0 is for tail length, which is most useful in the Crotales and Glockenspiel. G0 is for sound, with 5 editable EQ presets. Some playstyles have extra settings available, which will appear under the mic soundstage diagram, just here. Single hit play is simply a multi-sampled way of playing the instrument, with no special trickery. There are many round robins available, up to 30 per velocity layer, because in this type of instrument there can be many repeated notes, and you certainly don't want that dreaded machine gun effect. In bounce, a couple of trailing notes are generated after each note, simulating a physical mallet bouncing on the key. There are adjustable parameters for number of bounces and how far apart they'll be. That's time spread. Cluster play will generate a group of notes for each key played, being unique for each position in your door. Like bounce, you can set the number of notes and the time spread. And in this case, because there are various pitches too, you can also set a range for tonal spread in semitones up and down from the played key. Because the engine uses the door position as a cipher, subsequent playbacks will always remain consistent. Tremolo style has a couple more options. You can set the sustained level, the speed, specify whether there's a pronounced hit at the start, the end, or neither. Humanize the velocity. And finally, there are settings for sticking, where you can decide whether the play engine should play alternate notes, play them simultaneously, or choose based on tempo. If you drag the speed parameter all the way up, you can adjust speed by MIDI CC11 in real time. Auto tremolo is very much like tremolo, except it will only play tremolo when simultaneous notes are held. In grid mode, there are 5 presets for programmed sequences. You can customize these to your liking, setting the number of steps, the speed, and sticking method, and dragging the bars for either velocity or pitch. Your custom settings will be auto-saved with your project. If you make changes in standalone mode, make sure to resave your instrument to preserve them. Tail length is available in 3 options, which speaks for itself. Finally, there are 5 EQ presets. Like with grid mode, any changes here to the 5 presets will be auto-saved with your project. Some of the EQ presets are quite extreme and can make for interesting effects. Don't forget that there's more information about all the features and functions within the comprehensive Idiophones manual. And we can't wait to hear your compositions using the instruments. Thanks for watching.